We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Hello, America. Welcome to What Catches Fire. My name is James Kinney, your host from Kinney Group Creative. We're here in beautiful, sunny Los Angeles today. It's my first winter in Los Angeles, and I'm experiencing a little bit of the California winter, and I must say, it's not a winter at all. It's refreshing to have a little bit of a cooler temperature, because I know from what you guys have told me, this summer was a little hotter than usual. I live downtown where our office is, and it was probably 105, 106 a couple of days. So even though it was a dry heat, as they say, it was still pretty hot. I'm used to New York where, you know, it's hot, but it's so humid and so sticky. So I still will say that the California summer was much better. So now we're in California winter, and basically you guys just get a little bit of rain and that's it. Yes. So it's very, very nice to have a California winter. Going back to our New York office this coming Sunday. So next week I will be in full New York winter, which I don't know. The past couple of New York winters have been a little bit mild too. So we'll see. But I did buy a new coat, so I'll get a chance to use that coat. Thanks so much for tuning into the program today. All of our 200,000 plus listeners out there, thank you so much for tuning in and being brand loyal to my show and What Catches Fire. Very happy to have Ness on the boards today, engineering the show. Thank you, Ness, for being here as always. Justin Juarez, account director from Kinney Group Creative, and Matt Kirkwood, account manager from Kinney Group Creative as well. Shout out to our East Coast team and everybody here at LA Talk Live. Again, I always like to applaud LA Talk Live for such an amazing platform that you guys have put together. Broadcasting transmedia and communicating a message is easier than ever, and you guys have really found a fantastic way for people like myself and our firm to do that. So thanks again. A little quick updates on where we are with Kinney Group Creative. A little firm check-in. Lucinda Bassett, our best-selling author client, is rocking and rolling. We have meetings with Barnes & Noble coming up this week. We're really excited about her book. We've been in touch with Dr. Oz, the Doctors TV, Dr. Drew, a lot of doctors. We've been in touch with Dr. Dre. Just kidding. Dr. Dre doesn't actually do medicine, for those of you guys who don't know that. But we're real excited about Lucinda's book. She's been through a lot and worked really hard to get where she is. With Uwe Gourmet, our beverage brand, we have a pitch with Whole Foods. So that's really exciting for us. Whole Foods is the pinnacle of the organic and natural products business. So we're about to be in Whole Foods stores, which is really exciting. This past weekend here in Los Angeles, we shot a web commercial for Uwe Gourmet, and it went exceptionally well. So we're going to be releasing that video very soon. Speaking of inspired content, we just wrapped up a nationwide marketing campaign for our Inc. 500 client, Electronic Payments. Electronic Payments is about a $50 million brand that processes $3 billion in transactions per annum. And we flew around the country, literally from Kalamazoo to Miami to Fresno, and filmed an amazing series of inspired content for Electronic Payments. So we're about to finish that and put that out. What else? Right now we're doing work in Miami at Art Basel. We're working with Commune Hotels to put on an art series with our partners over in Europe. There's Parisian DJs that we've had flown in. It's a partnership with Bacardi and Commune Hotels. So Justin and I have literally been working since 6 a.m. this morning on the final touches for that event series in Miami. And then with Morgan's Hotel Group, we have a lot of exciting stuff going on as well. We're meeting with the agency group this week coming up in New York. The agency group is a top 5 talent agency in the world, almost like a CAA or William Morris, but they're more specific to music. We're doing a collaborative commerce project with the agency group, as well as a couple lifestyle brands and Morgan's Hotel Group as well, across three properties, Mondrian, Royalton, and the Hudson as well. So we've got a lot of exciting things going on. There's a few more. Aquadopa, a new brand that we're working with out of New Mexico. We're in the, I guess we're about a fourth of the way through that brand development process. And that brand is so fantastic. We're really excited about how this brand is going to look, feel, and taste, because it is a beverage brand. Anyhow, we have a really, really, really exciting guest on the show today. CBX, and just so you guys, in case you didn't hear me, it's CBX as in X-ray, not S as in Sam. CBX is one of the world's thought leaders on branding. Specifically consumer packaged goods. They've been around for years and years and years and work on literally the world's largest brands, from Kraft to Nestle. And I may be making some of this up, so I better get to my fact sheet. But I know for a fact, Gamco, General Mills, Giant Eagle, Amway, that my best friend Christine worked on their project, Office Depot, literally like the people who make everything we buy, that's who they do things for. Everything from positioning to package design, the way it looks, feels, they're geniuses at that. So today we're going to have Rick Barrack. Rick Barrack is the chief creative officer and managing partner at CBX. So go to their website, cbx.com, and you'll get a chance to look at how the big boys do it and how the big boys play this game of creating the things that we buy as consumers. We're going to take a short break and pay some bills and come right back to What Catches Fire on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Susie Pruden. And yes, you've seen me on Oprah, Good Morning America, and The Today Show. And I'm inviting you to join me every Monday from 3 to 4 for my new show, Mastermind Live. Join us as we introduce you to the new thought leaders of the world who will inspire you, support you, and guide you to your next level. So don't forget to tune into Mastermind Live exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B. Or watch us on Ustream TV. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Jennifer Tapiero from StarCam. You guys might know me from the red carpet, catching up with all the stars, but guess what? We're bringing the red carpet to the radio right out here on LA Talk Live. I'm going live Thursday nights at 6 p.m. We got hot topics, celebrities, and much more. We were featured on Chloe Lamar on E!, Howard Stern, T.I.'s Family Hustle. You know how we do. So check it out on Thursday nights, 6 p.m. All things Hollywood, everything celebrity. StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
StarCam Radio.
Oh yeah, follow us on Twitter at StarCam Radio.
And now, for their second and final appearance at the Beacon Theater, please welcome the Rolling Stones.
Settler. Okay, first song.
Something about the Rolling Stones, right? Now, that is quite a brand. You know, when you look at one of the most iconic logos ever designed, I think, the tongue and the lips and the mouth, from Rolling Stones. I think that's quite an amazing brand. If you think about how special that is, I just gotta look at that real quick on Google Images, because I mean that I don't know of any other band that has that kind of logo. It was Rolling Stone magazine, but then there's the Rolling Stones. The Rolling Stones are even bigger than Rolling Stone magazine, and Rolling Stone magazine is the media. So that is a great example of a great brand. Rick, are you with us?
I'm with you.
How you doing?
Good, guys. How are you?
Really good. Thanks so much for being on the show. I do know you're a busy man creating all those world-class brands, so thanks for taking a few moments out to talk with us.
No problem. I'm a huge Stones fan myself. So.
Oh, thanks. Did you hear what I was saying about the Rolling Stones?
I did not. I just came in on the end of that, but so I missed it.
Oh, well, I was saying that we were playing Rolling Stones for music in between the commercial, and I was saying, like, man, what a brand that is. Like, just the logo that the Rolling Stones used all alone. I mean, how many T-shirts have they sold just off of that brand alone?
Off of the tongue and lips, right?
Exactly.
And, what a huge brand, and what a testament to them for being able to withstand the forces of time, right?
Yeah.
Mean, they've transcended generations, and I think that they're playing here in New York soon, and even today prices for a ticket are just outrageous.
Oh, I know. I mean, I remember the last Grammy Awards Mick Jagger was performing, and he had more energy than every new little Justin Bieber or little Wayne could ever have.
Oh, no doubt. And huge Stones fan. Been to many of their concerts. One of the all-time greats, no doubt about it.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, Rick, thanks so much for being on the show once again. Just to give you a little bit of background about what the show is about, as you know, my firm has worked with your firm in the past on some of your events, so I'm very familiar with your brand. I've been to your office several times, and every time I go to your office, it's just an electric atmosphere of raw creativity. I remember the first time I came into your office there in New York, I heard someone playing old school Notorious B.I.G., and I said, man, this is really a creative place.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, so this show, we talk about the love, life, culture, and politics of the American brand. So we discuss legacy brands like a Harley Davidson up to new brands that are exciting, like a Zipcar, and you know how everything now is positioned like a lifestyle brand. So yeah. It's great to have you, someone with years and years of experience, to be on the line with us. And I guess if it's okay with you, I'd like to open up with and just ask you, since you're a founding partner, how did CBX get its start?
Well, interesting question. I'll try to keep it as short as possible.
We have plenty of time.
We started, I've been in this business a while, obviously, as you mentioned, back in late 90s, early 2000s, partners and myself who were part of a public company decided that it was time to jump out on our own. A public company and a branding company sometimes have different business goals. So. Mm-hmm. Being in the relationship business, we jumped out on our own and started actually, really a smart move on my behalf, I must say. My wife was pregnant with our first child, and I just bought a new house, and I quit my job to go start a new business. Not exactly the smartest move in the world. But we started with three people, basically, and the first job was out of the basement of my house. As my wife was having morning sickness, and we just built relationships. This business is about relationships, and mm-hmm. Is about making connections. And we've been very fortunate. We started with three people 10 years ago or so, and today we're 120, 100, somewhere between 120, 130 strong between two offices.
Wow. You know, as someone who started by myself out of my apartment, in New York, and now I have 6 employees. It's been a tremendous amount of work for me to get from where I was 2 years ago to where I am now. Rick, I wish I could just put a USB cable to your brain and try to learn from you.
But yeah. Hey, man, I'll tell you, it was a tremendous amount of hard work, as you well know. And, yeah. You know, this business is very difficult and can be very difficult. And all-nighters and working 24/7, you know, 7 days a week, that's really, you know, nose to the grindstone, so to speak. That's how we built the business. And you know, I often say that we use the amount of people sometimes to exhibit or illustrate the amount of growth that we've had. You know, we've been fortunate. We were listed in Inc. 5000 as one of the fastest growing companies some years ago. But I will tell you that it isn't about the amount of employees that you have. I mean, it is about the clients and the relationships you build, and the employee count is really a manifestation or a result of those relationships that we've been very, very humbled and fortunate to have.
Very well said. Yeah. Well, Rick, now what, speaking of those 110 plus employees that you guys have, what type of clients do you serve with those employees?
Well, we got into the business because we love all things brand. And mm-hmm. And again, as I stated, not to be redundant here, but you know, we've had many great relationships, and we've tried to span those relationships over a number of types of disciplines. We big, small clients, Fortune 500 clients, to upstarts, to mass, to class categories. We have retail clients that are specific to retail. We have strategy clients that are specific to strategy. Packaging, obviously, as you mentioned in the opening, is a big part of it. You know, we do it all, and we're a holistic company that has many many disciplines in-house, and to serve a number of different types of size clients and different categories as well.
Yeah, that's, you know, it's so interesting. I know, sitting where I am at 2.5 years, going on 3, and our businesses are a little different, but at the end of the day, I think they're very similar in that it's strongly relationship based. And, you know, we do branding, but it's different than what you all do in the sense that, we try to work on, collaborative commerce, and collaborative commerce is something that we're really rolling out strong in 2013. And I was really looking forward to talking to you about this. And basically what we mean by collaborative commerce is that, you know, we'll help you create a brand and understand who you are as a business and how consumers relate to your brand. But then how does your brand work with other brands? You know, how are you playing well in the sandbox? So we help companies understand, hey, if you're a fashion company, you may want to partner with the music company. You also may want to partner with a automotive company. And our job is to connect the dots and help that brand figure out how could they partner with an automotive company, and what does that look like, and what does that sound like? So that's the kind of work that we like to do. So as far as collaborative commerce and the 360 touch points, if you will, around a brand, where do you see that going? You know, because it's social media, the internet, mobile, I mean, things are crazy right now. And for someone who's been branding, you know, large and small companies for 20 years plus, where do you see this going?
Well, good question. That's a heavy question.
Yeah.
It's you know, I don't know where it's going. I mean, I'm not a fortune teller, but I will tell you, I can tell you that as a company, we believe that there, because of the things that you just mentioned, mm-hmm. The 360 degree, brand doesn't, you know, it used to be that brand just stopped at having a nice graphic designed package or logo or what have you. And today, because of that 360 degree impact, Branding is not just about how it looks anymore. It's not just about how it appears and how it's staged in the marketplace, but it's also critically important to understand what you're communicating and how you're communicating it. So it's visual and verbal, mm-hmm. And then to your point, the adjacencies or the connections that one brand is making to an audience, mm-hmm. and knowing that audience, and having a good sense of what that audience is about, the purpose piece, the belief system, getting into some of the foundational aspects of the audience or the consumer and connecting the dots. And I think the dot connection piece to this, without being too esoteric, mm-hmm. is really critical at a 360 degree world.
Right.
And so you've got to be able to not just have a great looking package, but you've got to have a great naming system. You've got to have a good brand architecture. You've got to have a good verbal strategy so that you know what your voice is. And mm-hmm. and if you have a good sense of that, then and you work with your client to understand that, then it should be a dull moment at that point, because you telegraph exactly how and what you need to do.
Yeah. Yeah, well, thank you for that insight, and I'm sure that the listeners and callers out there can gain a lot of insight from what you were saying. It sounds like to me what you're saying and just how we break it down to how we live our lives. Isn't it these days, Rick, more about a story? You know, like what kind of story totally. Is the brand telling?
Totally.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah.
Absolutely. And your point of difference and you know, how is that, you know, as an example, for instance, how is that the brand transcends, because it's 360 today, it's not just the package on shelf, it's the entire journey, right? It's mm-hmm. it's from the moment of purchase, it's to the experience you have at home with the product. It's if you have a problem with the product and you call customer service, how is customer service going to respond?
Thank you for saying
what
that.
What are they going to say? And how are they going to verbalize? And on Facebook and on social media, mm-hmm. what's the communication strategy there that supports the message that you're sending, that you're delivering at the point of purchase? And, critically important, all the way from brand to channel.
Oh, Rick, thank you. I mean, hallelujah. Thank you for saying that, because I think so few people get it. You know, we like sometimes we'll work with a client and maybe it'll just be like on something that's music related and not really even brand related. But we tell them that we're creating a brand experience on their behalf. And then right. somebody will come in and they'll have terrible service. And then I tell them, I say, you know what? No matter what we do to create an atmosphere or any sort of brand on your behalf that makes sense, if everything in the value chain does not check off, the brand is not what we sell it to be.
That's right.
Period.
That's yeah. absolutely. I'll tell you, just to build on this without laboring it too much, mm-hmm. is that, if you think about it, you think about what it used to be like, right? The relationship between the brand and the consumer was a one-way street. Mm-hmm. It was a one-way street. Right. It was. Here's our brand, and this is what we're going to tell you, consumer, or audience, or purchaser. Mm-hmm. But today, in the 360 degree world, and in the life that you and I live now, mm-hmm. The consumer has much more impact in what the brand impression is. So, and that's critically important to understand. And even if any given agency is it's not their wheelhouse to deliver digital strategy or broadcast media, it's critically important to have a fully integrated approach to that so that everybody's aware and marching to the same drum. Mm-hmm. So one firm is in charge of delivering the brand impression. Another firm is in charge of delivering social media, Another firm is in charge of delivering broadcast media. Again, the messaging there and knowing the importance of how that two-way conversation happens today is critically important.
Absolutely. Well, that's valuable for the listeners to understand that value chain process, because a lot of people think that when you say that, oh, CBX does branding, and they just think that it's like, oh, okay, cool, they make logos, and you're like, no,
right.
that's a small
that's right.
part of the whole experience.
Absolutely.
Now, Rick, if you and you don't have to go too far into this, because I know that it's very elaborate, but if you could share with us the creative process behind the work you do for a client and what that feels like, meaning is it you and five people in a room with a whiteboard, or is it you on a sheet of paper just with a ballpoint pen? How does that creative process start?
Well, you know, I would tell you this. I'll start with this and tell you that every client, I mean, I don't have to tell you this, you know this, but you know, every client's different. And the process that you go through creatively, you know, is I wouldn't say a customized and reinvented approach every time. There's certainly foundational elements that you follow, but or methodologies that you follow, but you know, each client is different, and depending upon the speed to market and speed to ideas and how do you get those ideas quickly and what the goals are of any given initiative, the process changes. But that being said, you know, I think for us personally, CBX, we believe in the immersion aspect. I know that you've had this, you've talked about this on your show before. You know, immersion is everything. There's a great quote by Einstein. Here we're going to quote Einstein. Can you believe it? like that hasn't been done before. but a great, he did have a great quote, right? And the quote is, you know, if I had 1 hour to save the world, I would spend 55 minutes defining the problem and only 5 minutes finding the solution. And I got to tell you, I love that quote. Yeah. I mean, I just love that quote. I think the creative process is very much like that. You really have to immerse yourself, understand the problems, be fully engaged, and then once you do that, I think the solutions become a dull moment. To be honest with you, and that's really, I think, our premise for finding solutions. And when you get to those solutions, it becomes not a 1+1=2 moment, but a 1+1=3 moment, and you really open up the possibilities of what the solution can be.
Yeah, you know, I've met with members of your strategy team, your PR team, as well as your account directors, and you have some exceptionally smart people that are working for you, and they get it.
Yeah, well, I appreciate that very much. We're very humbled, and you know, we approach life very humbled. I think that it's very, very important when you talk about whiteboards and that type of thing, that what we need to always do, at least here at CBX, is remind ourselves that the real world is not inside a boardroom, is not inside a conference room, is not inside any of those rooms, and it doesn't exist on a whiteboard. It exists by making sure that we're all tapped into what's going on out there in the marketplace from a consumer perspective, and making sure that we're connecting to people in a real manner. And we could spin all types of brand hyperbole and such, but at the end of the day, it doesn't address a mother with two children who works during the day, who struggles to make sure she has enough time for her kids and her family, and has real world challenges. And I think that everything we do, we filter that lens through it.
Rick, I can't tell you how refreshing it is to speak to you. And there are lots of people that have our perspective on what the real world actually is, because that was my next question. So my next question was, what makes CBX different from other branding firms? But I can't ask you that now, because you just answered it.
I didn't mean to steal your thunder there, James.
No. There's no thunder, because you brought the lightning. No, that's amazing, because that's what it's all about. And, you know, it's so funny. We were in the office yesterday, and we were watching these cool web videos on, like, shoemakers and coat makers and independent people that are making one product and literally putting their whole life into making a quality pair of shoes. And we said, you know what, this is raw and authentic. And then we looked at a couple big social media firms, and I'm not going to call anyone out, but you've seen it, Rick. It's these flashy, crazy videos with techno music, and it's like, we take your brand from A to Z and social media, advertising. And I was like, that's not what we want to be at all. I want to work directly with a company and say, listen, we're here to solve problems at the end of the day. Absolutely. That's what we're here to do.
Yep.
Yeah.
Totally agree. Go ahead. Sorry.
Oh, no, that's all right. Well, Rick, if you don't mind, we're going to take a short break to pay some bills and hear some more Rolling Stones music. So hold on the line for a brief second. And when we come back, I want to talk about the man behind the brand. So we're going to talk about your obsession for IndyCar. we're going to talk about music. We're going to talk about your family life. You know, I want to get to know Rick a little bit more.
Okay, you bet.
We'll be right back. Hold on the line, please. All right, Rick, you still there?
I'm here, guys.
Oh, thanks so much. For ladies and gentlemen, for those of you guys who aren't listening, that was enough time for Rick to create a full marketing strategy campaign.
Let me tell you, I love the Stones, man. That was some. And listen, any station, any show that can play Jamiroquai and the Rolling Stones and make it work, I'm a big fan.
Thanks, Rick. I appreciate that. That means that's huge coming from you. So let's get down to, so you have been to 39 consecutive years of Indy.
Oh, please.
Now So tell us about your obsession, if I may call it that, with racing.
Yeah, wow. Okay. Boy. That is a not that I'm struggling to talk about, because I could talk about this for hours, but the you know, I do believe that you know, in life you kind of, you got to have things that you're passionate about, and certainly branding is certainly one of them. There's no doubt about that. I wouldn't be in the business if I wasn't passionate about what we do for a living. Mm-hmm. But there's a, you know, there's other things that I'm very passionate about. I haven't missed an Indianapolis 500 in years, and it may stem back, without getting too deep, to family roots and fond family memories of it. But it is true. I'm not ashamed to admit it. You know, planned the birth of my two daughters around that month, and that is by far one of the most tremendous events. If you haven't had an opportunity, there is nothing like it. Certainly on TV it doesn't do it justice, but when you have 300,000 to 400,000 people and a one-day event and the traditions that are involved, and I'm a big traditional guy, a big mm-hmm. traditionalist in that manner, that thing's been going on for 100 years, and you're part of it, and it is a tremendous, I tell you, talk about brands, that is a tremendous brand that has been able to withstand the test of time over a number of years, and I'm a huge fan of it, for sure.
Absolutely. Yeah, and so it's very interesting that you say that. I was talking to a colleague in New York the other day, and a woman from CBS, that's S as in Sam, not X as in CBX, that we work with here in Los Angeles. And we were talking about how important it is for people who live the nexus of art and commerce, which we both do, how important it is to have other things that balance your life. And you have a background in theater as well, right?
Yeah, I do. That's right. I started my, you know, marketing is theater, so maybe there's a tie, but mm-hmm. who knows? But, you know, I started, you know, I think this course was charted for me very early on. I mean, from high school, basically, through today. There was only two ways for me to go. I was going to go the automotive route, or I was going to go the design route. And went the design route, and charted for me since high school. Went to the Youth Forming Arts High School. Went to Carnegie Mellon. Started in theater wanted to do stage design and theater design, and realized that business is maybe even more difficult than this business, mm-hmm. and decided to do a career change. But you know, there's lots of skills that were applied there that are applied here. And at the end of the day, you know, knowing is certainly part of it. Passion is certainly part of it. Believing in something and being able to communicate it and illustrate it. And mm-hmm. and that's where I started, which was a theater. And we actually have at CBX, believe it or not, we have a number of people here that have theater backgrounds. And I think it really is, not that I'm partial, but I do think it's a benefit to our business by having those people associated with theater. It really helps with the client communication and being able to formulate and sell ideas.
Absolutely. Have you ever seen one of your brands on an Indy car or a stock car?
Well, yeah, sure. We've seen a number of them. Matter of fact, you know, I think Snapple is certainly one that we had been involved in, and that's been on there. And there's been a number, and it's quite, whether it's an Indy car, James, I'll tell you, whether it's an Indy car or whether it's an ad on TV. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's a moment for any designer, pure designer now, or anybody who's part of the developing of that positioning. I always say that at the end of the day, you know, after you go through this really interesting journey of building brands and positionings and such, the reward is you go home and you sit down and you see an ad on TV, or you see a car, race car, whatever it may be, and you see that brand on there, and you go, wow, I was part of that. Maybe in some small way, maybe in some large way, but you are part of that, the fabric of that brand in some way. And whether it's a brand that's been established for years, over years and has a tremendous amount of equity, or whether it's just a brand new brand that just started yesterday. I think that that to me is, I tell the creatives here, that that is a rewarding moment that you should just use as a moment to reflect on your careers and how you've influenced some of these brands. It's a wonderful moment.
Yeah, that's amazing. So you get to see the brand in front of you at 0 miles per hour, or you can see it in front of you at 160 miles per hour.
It doesn't matter. It's still rewarding.
Yeah, exactly. If it's 160, you may not be able to see it that well, but you know that you worked on it.
Right. Yeah. Car goes around at, 200 miles an hour. You go, wait. I want to show you something.
I know.
Damn it, I missed it.
I know. What? Don't worry. It'll come around again. that's funny. And to your point of having people having diverse backgrounds, your associate director of public relations, Christine Coppinger, who obviously you know very well.
Yeah.
When I first moved to New York, she was actually my manager when I was a full-time touring musician.
That's right.
Yes. Right. So she's had her hand in the music business, and I've had it in front of the stage, and now we're all sitting here a few years later. And
isn't that something?
Yeah, it's so cool how it continues to evolve.
Yeah, I'll give you a quick. I don't mean to take this off on an exit ramp, but I'll give you a quick. I believe in fate. I do believe in fate, and I you asked me how did we get started, and when we first started our business, it was on 32nd Madison. It was a shoebox here in New York, as you well know.
I lived on 32nd and Madison.
Say that again?
I lived on 32nd and Madison.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So you know the area. So yeah. Everything in New York is a shoebox. But so this is a real shoebox. And only to know, if I knew what I, at that moment, what I was to come to know. And that was 10 years earlier, maybe about 10 years. When I first moved to New York, small town kid out of Louisville, Kentucky, and I had my portfolio case in hand and started jobs, sleeping on couches, whatever I was doing, I found my first apartment in New York City. And this was 10, maybe even 15 years prior to that.
Mm-hmm.
And where was my first apartment that I was struggling to make rent and working day and night, getting my creative chops? It was on 32nd and Madison. So if you would have told me 10 years earlier than that, in 10, 15 years, whatever the time frame is, you will be part of a design firm or a creative or a brand agency that in 10 years' time that will be right around the corner with three people. And then fast forward from that, 10 years later, you'll have 120, 140 people, whatever the number is.
Wow.
You'll be working with some of the biggest brands and being privileged enough to be part of those. I would have said you're completely out of your mind. Completely out of your mind. So it's really interesting you talk about Christine, but it's all about fate, really.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that is so encouraging for us to hear. And we thank you humbly for just sharing that story. And for those of you who are listening, really what you need to take in is what Rick's saying, that basically through sleepless nights, hard work, and vision and determination and character, I think the biggest thing that I take away from the conversation that we're having with you today, Rick, is it's all about character and integrity. You mentioned relationships 7 or 8 times when we started the call. And I think young marketers and young branders, designers, et cetera, you need to understand that relationships and character is how you build what Rick has built over the past few decades. So Yeah. And even weirder, I wound up living on 32nd Madison, and I had my first office, Rick, for my firm was at 167 Madison on the corner of 33rd Madison. And now we're on the radio together.
Yeah, so someone had told me that, 15, 20 years later, you'd be on the radio with the guy that lived right around the corner for you. I mean, you're really out of your mind.
That's so cool. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have been on the line with Rick Barrack, who is the Chief Creative Officer for CBX. He was named one of the top 100 most creative people in the globe, just for you guys who don't know who we've been speaking to on the phone. And Rick is obviously a very humble guy, but we just wanted to let the audience know who we've been speaking to in full. Rick, is there anything else that you would like to say to the audience or myself in closing?
No, I think you hit it. You know, I think I would just be redundant if I said anything, but now that you've given me the stage to say it, maybe I will.
Please.
I do think that, relationships are very important. Certainly, we've built our business on relationships and helping our clients, most importantly, helping our clients navigate the garden path of their respective lives and business goals. And to achieve what they need to achieve with their brands, and I think I think what's made us very successful is understanding that and I would give the advice to anybody is that it's not always just about design. There's lots of creative people out there, lots of really really good creative people, and people sometimes ask me. What makes your company different? And I say I don't know whether or not our creative is better than the shop down the street. I really don't. There's lots of great creative people, but what I do think that is very important is this, that we make it a point to understand our client, the challenges that they're going through, and have some empathy. And realize that sometimes our job isn't just about designing or being a strategist, but sometimes our job is about being a psychologist and empathizing with our clients' needs and wants and desires. And I think that's an important aspect for anybody who's in this business to understand that those are certainly foundational aspects of success.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, Rick Barrack from CBX, one of Fast Company's 100 most creative people in business. Rick, thank you so much. I'm so humbled to speak to you and grateful for this opportunity. We're going to make sure that you get this complete series between you and I so you guys can use that for your social media purposes and branding purposes, because you got to brand yourself.
That's right.
Yeah. But Rick, I'll be in town next week. Would love to see you in person again at some point. But thank you, Christine, from your firm for putting this together for us. This is What Catches Fire on LA Talk Live, where we are more than just
James.
Talk. Thanks,
appreciate
Rick.
Appreciate it very much, guys.
Absolutely.
Okay. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. And we're going to take a short commercial break. We'll be right back to wrap up the show. Thanks so much.
Walk, run, climb, play. Solgar number 7 can help. Feel the difference for yourself. Solgar number 7 actually shows improvement in joint comfort within 7 days. Now you can start to get back on track fast and pursue the activities you love. Solgar number 7 is a breakthrough in joint care with no glucosamine and no chondroitin. The advanced bioactives in Solgar number 7 help to increase flexibility, mobility, range of motion, and actually shows improvement within just 7 days. One capsule, once a day, is all you need. When stiff joints occasionally say no, Solgar number 7 says yes. Visit Solgar.com and learn more about Solgar number 7 today. That's www.solgar.com, www.solgar.com. Solgar number 7, official sponsors of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane and LA Talk Live.
Oh, your skin looks great.
Thank you.
What's your secret?
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence.
Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence?
Yes, it's a beauty secret used since the time of the Greeks and the Romans. This spa in Malibu told me about frankincense and myrrh by Ancient Essence, and now my skin is lovely.
Yes, your skin looks great.
Call Ancient Essence at 1-800-627-9813. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Call 1-800-627-9813. 9813. Discover the secret. Frankincense and myrrh oil by Ancient Essence. Discover the secret of beautiful skin. Available at fine spas and beauty centers.
Thanks so much for coming back to What Catches Fire. I am your host, James Kinney. What a wonderful show today. I feel inspired. I feel re-energized. It's such a great opportunity to even to speak to someone like Rick Barrack from CBX. CBX really is an amazing company. I know several of their employees, and there's a company culture that they have that is congruent throughout their whole enterprise. Everybody from the person when you walk in the front door, and they actually have theater curtains in their office. I wonder if Rick had something to do with that. But there is an organic and a genuine experience that you get when you walk in the doors at CBX. They just get it. They're just doing it right. You know, I guess I could go on and on, but some people just get it, and they get it, and they've got it going on. That's it. Thank you so much for the staff here at LA Talk Live. For all of our listeners out there, I really hope you enjoyed the show today. Make sure to go to @CBXTweets or CBX.com for more information on CBX. Of course, you know how to get a hold of us at KGCNY. Email me directly, james@kinneygroupcreative.com. I'd love to talk to you, find out what your needs are, what your challenges are. Let us attempt to solve those for you. And if you're a multi-billion dollar company, you can call CBX. But if you've, you know, you're kind of smaller, you're looking for a deal, you can call us. All right. Thanks so much. It's been a fantastic show. Next week, I'm in New York, and then I'm back. And next couple shows, we've got a wonderful artist named Alpha, who's a fantastic singer. You guys are going to love this girl. She's living at 30,000 feet for sure. And then we have a girl. Matt, what's her name?
Kelly.
Kelly, what's her last name? Do you remember? Well, we have Kelly, who has been on Glee. So we have a Glee cast member on the show next week. So that's pretty exciting to have someone on from Glee. Bum, bum, bum. Bum, 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 bum. All right. Take care. We'll see you next week. What Catches Fire?
We know there are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.